We are Infinity Song. And we are so honored to be here with you all today. Thank you so much for coming out. It's late, I know. But this is going to be the vibiest show of the night. Hi. My name is Abraham.
I'm Victory.
I'm Momo.
Hey, I'm Angel.
And I'm Israel.
Every time I tell the people around me about my plans and my vivid fancy dream, singing life, saying living in a fantasy, then they say it's time to come back to reality. But I never, ever, ever let it bother me, cause I know who I am and where I'm gonna be. They can say what they wanna say about me.
It's okay, cause I'm gonna live far away. It's okay, cause I'm gonna live far away. It's okay, cause I'm gonna live far away.
I keep thinking about the possibilities. I will the car fly it over the sand. That's what I told my teacher and she said to me, I can tell you've been watching too much TV. It's okay if she doesn't believe in me. I let her know when I make it to my destiny. They can say what they wanna say about me.
It's okay, cause I'm gonna live far away. It's okay, cause I'm gonna live far away. It's okay, cause I'm gonna live far away. What can I say? What can I do? I keep the hope alive until I get to you. To the other side, I don't have to worry, cause I'll be just a vibe when they see me flying. They can say what they wanna say about me. It's okay, cause I'm gonna live far away. One day when I am who I'm supposed to be, I look back and oh, that day I'm free. Even though they never believed in me, I hope they find their destiny. They don't care what other people have to say. We'll see the day when we all live far away. Far away.
And I'm a dreamer. I'm a dreamer. I'm a believer. And I'm a dreamer. I'm a dreamer. I'm a believer and I'm dreaming. 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 I'm a believer and I'm dreaming.
Popping champagne out here?
Absolutely.
So this next song is off our album. Who's heard our album?
Love the enthusiasm, guys.
It was the lead-off single of our album. It's called Everything Is Gonna Be Alright. It goes like this. Everything is gonna be all right.
Choose to watch while the world break up and fall on me. All the while
my mind.
Hey.
It's called Just Loving Me. If you've heard our album, then you've heard this song. We had the honor of working with a very amazing producer called Jerry Wunda. And he's worked with some legends called, he's worked with legends like the Fugees, Wyclef Jean, Miss Lauryn Hill, Carlos Santana. Like, he has a really long roster. So we were really honored to work with him on this song. And when we worked on it with him, it came out to be like this really like, classic R&B song, but I want to take you guys back to like when I first wrote this song. When I first wrote it, it was just me and my guitar, so that's how I'm gonna sing it for you guys today. It's called Just Let Me Listen to It.
Change who I am.
love me for me.
This next song that we're going to perform, I'm pretty sure everybody in here knows it. If you don't know it, you are in the minority in the room. This song is special to us. It's our first viral cover ever. So how many of you all were introduced to us through Instagram? Let's see. Quite a few of you, yeah. So you probably have heard this one. Let's just say
that. I know your eyes in the morning sun. I feel you touch me in the pouring rain. And the moment that you wander far from me, I wanna feel you in my arms again. And you come to me on a summer breeze, keep me warm in your love and you softly. And it's me you need to show.
How deep is your love?
It's your love, how deep is your love? I really need your love, 'cause we're living in a world of fools, breaking us down, and they all shine where us be. We belong to you and me.
I believe in you. You know the door to my very soul.
Shut up,
how deep is your love?
But these last couple of years really have been a ringer. I don't even know if that's the right word. Even still, there's a place to find solace. Why should discouraged, and why should the shadows curve, and why should my heart feel lonely and long for heaven and home? When Jesus is my portion, a constant friend is he. His eyes are the sparrow, and I know that he watches over me. Let not your heart be troubled. His tender sparrow. is watching over me. Watching over me, he's watching over you. He's watching over the sparrow, and that's how come that I know that he's watching over me. I know way down in my heart that Jesus is watching. It's easy to go places when the wind is at your back. It's almost like you're flying. It's no resistance, no friction. You just go with the wind. But what do you do? What do you do when your dreams are on the other side of the wind? Opposite direction from which the wind is blowing. Well, you press against the wind. This journey is a process that's making me strong. I can't stay in one place too long. I can hear my destiny calling me out from where I am. So I'm bracing against the wind. I am bracing against the wind.
It's all right, come on, sing.
It's blowing my veins, but I'm pressing against the wind. Against the wind.
reason why I won't stop singing. It's why my heart's still beating.
Song that I'm working on that I'm kind of excited about. It's so premature, but you know, it's the 10 o'clock show. May as well. So this song is so funny to me. It's called Haters Anthem. And I find it so funny because, you know, there are so many haters in the world. And I gotta be honest, sometimes I'm one of them. You know, like sometimes it's so easy to fall in like the pit of, you know, just being miserable and hating everything that you're not doing. Like I could do that better, you know? And so I feel like it's a common thing with artists. It's like you feel like you can do better. And so it's like, do better. Do better instead of feeling like you can do better, actually do better. Anyway, so this song is like from that perspective, and so it's a little bit satirical. So I'm gonna see if you guys get it. Oh, also I only wrote the chorus and the ending, so don't expect the verse. So this is the chorus and this is how it goes. 'Cause I love the way it feels to be a hater. Something so sweet about thinking that I'm better. Just to wake up every morning, lay in bed, and somehow never ever rise to the occasion, or even hold up under pressure. But we all know that it doesn't. If I was swaying all the things I'm clever, just as long I've got my ego and it tells me I'm superior, I could probably go a lifetime being barely mediocre. I still convince myself every time that I'm line, but I'd rather be dissatisfied with everything
Thank you. It's almost embarrassing to sing because it's so honest. Like, I I feel like the more that you hate, it's very obvious or very evident that that's the time when you're doing the least. Because when you're focused on your vision and your goal and your calling, you're not worried about anybody else. So when I'm doing the least, I usually am hating the most. So make sure you do. Make sure you do what you need to do so you don't, you know, have to identify with that song too much. It's okay to identify with it a little, but don't make it really be your anthem. Okay, so...
Do better!
Exactly. So this next song, it's a little bit more... nice. This song is called Born to Fly. I wrote this song about a year ago. Listen to the lyrics. I won't forget you when I say my prayers at night. I'll pray for you.
Thank you.
I'm gonna give you guys the spiel for that song. That song is pretty much, it's about believing in somebody 100%. And a lot of times, we don't have that. Especially artists, we don't have people who believe in us 100%. Sometimes it's really hard to find people to believe in you. And so I really encourage everybody in here to believe in the people in your lives 100%, because there's not just a select few who are born to fly. Every single person born on this earth is born to fly. But a lot of times we don't realize that because we don't have the community to uplift us. And so you have to create the community right there. You have to create the community, and you have to tell the person right next to you in your everyday life, who you see every day, who you take for granted, I believe in you. So I challenge everybody to do that in their everyday lives, because that's very important, and it can change life.
You know what that means? Buy people's stuff.
Without a discount.
Not with, yes, exactly. With that, yes, yes. Currency, like financial support, is like huge to the people who are attempting to do something great in your life. So, you know, don't be afraid to pay full price for your boy. Like, don't be afraid to pay full price for your friend. Like, you should be the first one in line to buy their stuff.
Like, he said this last show, and we had this whole joke where we were like, and that means buy our merch and stuff, but I'm not even gonna do that. I'm just gonna tell y'all to go buy our merch. No joke.
That is, they're disconnected points, although we do want you. Alan and Michelle are outside, on the side. But those are totally disconnected points. So support your friends, guys.
Always.
Dedicate this song to not just, as much as I want to say, the people who buy merch, but not just them. I want to dedicate this song to everybody who came out tonight and is supporting us. Because you guys are right or die. When I'm traveling through darkness, will you be right there? Be the light that I need in my times of need. In the harshest of territories, be the guide that I need. And when I'm feeling like I can't go on no more, cause my heart's on the floor and my spirit's no more, will you push me back on my feet? I need someone to warm, leave me all on my own. When I'm not at my best, when things they look a mess, I need someone who will tell me that this is real. Cause I ain't about all that pain. I guess what I am seeing is, baby, is it you? Are you my right die? Can I count on you when the world's not on my side? And baby, is it you? Are you here through thick or thin? Will you be here when it's hard to make amends? And when I'm feeling like I'm falling down 100 stories and I truly believe no one can save me, will you swoop and help me fly like I'm free till we land safely? And when it's looking like I might crash, cause I'm going too fast and my foot's on the gas and my thinking was crass, will you be there in the passenger seat? I need someone to warm, leave me all on my own. When I'm not at my best, when things they look a mess, I need someone who will tell me that this is real. Cause I ain't about that pain. I guess what I'm saying is, baby, is it you? Are you my ride or die? Side. But maybe is it you? Are you here through thick or thin? Will you be here when it's hard to make amends?
Die. Can I count on you
my side. And baby, is it you? Are you here through thick or thin? Are you being when it's hard to make amends?
Y'all are giving the 8 o'clock a run for their money. I'm gonna just say that.
It feels so good to be in New York City doing a show. We've done a few shows in this acoustic series that we're doing right now, and they've been, some of them in the middle of nowhere, some of them in cool places like Chicago, but ain't no place like New York City! Yeah, there's just no place like this place. We
love y'all too, Chicago.
But New York is one of the places that made us, and it made our music, and it made us the performers that we are today. Gave us a story, the story that we have, which we'll have to say for another time. We're not a time. But, yeah. Is there anyone here who maybe heard, has seen us, like, not on Instagram, but...
Bethesda Fountain!
Yeah. So you guys know what we're talking about right now. So.
Well, they're real ride or dies then. Y'all saw us before it was up.
Yeah.
Man, that... These three, how many of, who's seen us in Central Park or in the subway? That's pretty good.
Okay, let's give a little backstory for people who didn't see us there. Before everything, like before we got signed and everything, we used to do like street performing for a really long time as a family with our dad, and we did that for most of my life. I think 14 like 13, 14 years. We would street perform in Detroit, where we're from, and a lot of different places. And then we came to New York because obviously there's always mad tourism and just a lot going on. So when Detroit kind of went bankrupt, we moved over here, and we were just, you know, performing every single day for people who would pass by and, you know, support us with money. And so it's been a really long journey. So to have people who have, you know, supported us from those times to the point where we're like actually on a stage is really cool. So thank you. Also, surprisingly, even though we've really been in New York like our whole lives, this has actually been like our first headlining show. The show before this, we sold out, which was really, really awesome. Our first headlining show sold out ever. This one obviously isn't sold out, but but we love
it
you.
It makes it no less important, though.
Exactly. Yeah. So you guys actually are really getting like our first like headlining show in New York, like in an actual venue.
Also, I think this is. People were rushing to that 8 o'clock show, but actually we're doing a lot more music and a lot more talking in this show, so...
Alright, so this song you may have heard of before. I've just been told not to say the name.
Let them be surprised.
So there we go.
Do sing if you know it, though.
Still, it's hard remembering what you had.
feel this, I'll remember it. What you had,
what you lost,
and what you lost.
Let's start singing before this turns into Magic Mike.
sit down.
I'm kidding, I don't dance like that.
Your dancing privileges revoked.
No more dancing. No more.
This next song is called When the Rain Starts.
Yes.
It's off the album. I feel like this was a really cool song to record and everything. It was a really cool process with this song. And Angel directed a music video for it. If you haven't seen it, check it out. I really like that one.
Wait, who's seen this music video? Okay.
Not enough people.
There are like seven people in
here. That's a good amount of people.
Thank you for the views to the ones who did see it. Thank you.
New York City. Today has been beautiful. This evening has been amazing. Thank you all so much for coming out. This has been the highest honor to be with you. We've got one more song. I think everybody here probably knows this one. So, if you don't know this song, well, enjoy it.
This song, I'm gonna say, Israel wrote this song, and he says that he wrote it mad quickly, but it's been like the staple for this rotation. Like, it's the title of our album. We perform it all the time. Like, we were able to perform it on the Soul Train Awards. We performed it on The Late Show with Stephen Colbert. I don't know if anybody saw that performance. That was a really cool highlight. It's really just been like the staple. So shout out to you for writing this.
Also, before we get off the stage, I just want to make sure that we acknowledge our parents who are not in this room tonight, but we would not be here without our dad and our mom that pushing us, propelling us, supporting us. Our dad is our manager, so we work with him like every day. So I just wanted to give honor where honor is due. All right, let's get into it.
One, two, three, go.
Even though I don't say it now.
City. We are Infinity Song. Thank you so much to the historic Cafe Wa for having us. Thank you so much to everyone who traveled to come see us. Thank you so much. We love you all. Everybody get home safely.